Assalamu alaikum dear students. Students, we are doing the revision of haloalkanes and haloarenes. Today we are going to start with the physical properties of the compounds. Okay, so first of all, alkyne halides are colorless when pure, but when they are exposed, they are developing the colors. They develop the colors when the sunlight is falling on them. So you can just say that because of the sunlight, some changes are taking place, and that is why the color is developed. Many volatile halo compounds are sweet in smell. They are giving sweet smells. Okay. Next, melting point and boiling point. Dear students, if we talk about the melting point and boiling point, we have to remember something which is related with their mass and which is related with their symmetry. That if we talk about the particular compound's formation, see, if you are having alkane and if you are having haloalkanes and both the masses are same, still there will be a change in their melting point and boiling point. Reason behind it, when you talk about the alkanes, it does not have polarity. There is no polarity in the compound. But if you talk about the haloalkanes, there is a polarity. We talked about CX bond, which was having partial positive charge and partial negative charge. So if an exam, it is asked that why does the same mass of the alkanes are having a different, or you can say lower boiling point or melting point, and why the haloalkanes, though it is with the same mass, it is having the boiling point and melting point higher one. So you can give the reason, because of the polarity, the attraction is more. That is the reason. One more important thing, if you have one particular compound and if you are having different structures, what do we call it? We call it isomers, right? Same molecular formula, different structural formulas. So in this case, one example is given, 1, 2, 3, 4, butane, Br is there, bromobutane. So you are able to see 1 bromobutane, 2 bromobutane, and you can say that is again with your 2 bromobutane. But they are in a different form. This is the straight chain compound. This is one branch and this is two branch. Is it clear? So we saw that the boiling point is changing, like when you have this straight chain, your boiling point is 375. Means you have to give more temperature. If it is having one branch, it is reduced. Kam ho gaya. 364. And if still it is reduced because of the two branching, so what is the reason? More the surface area. More the surface area, lesser the boiling point, boiling point. Here having less surface area. Here it is totally in the straight chain. So one thing very important, when it is in the straight chain, many of the particles will be there contact. And that is a packed structure. Because of the packing, you have to give the more temperature. That is the reason why the isomers are having different kind of the boiling point. More the surface area, lesser will be the boiling point. Again, you are having different structures over here, ortho, beta and para. So again, as you are having the different positions of your Cl, you are again having a different symmetry. And because of the different symmetry, there is a change in the boiling point and melting point. So here you are able to see boiling point is 453, 446 and 448. So it is changed over here. That is the reason, because of the symmetry. And melting point, that is 256, 249, 323. Let me tell you, this is because of the symmetry. It is symmetrical. When you draw this straight line, one part is a mirror image of the another. And because of the symmetrical nature, this both are unsymmetrical. So they are having a different boiling point, melting point. And this is having a different melting point. That is the reason behind their structures. Next, if we talk about density, density is mass upon volume. So here you are able to see mass upon volume. The compound of your density is given over here, which you can relate. So there is a, depending on the mass upon the volume, your compound is going to have the density. Solubility. Let me tell you, this is very important point. The haloalkanes are very slightly soluble in water. In order to dissolve haloalkanes in water, energy is required to overcome the attraction between the particles or the molecules and break the hydrogen bonds between the water molecules. polar, if your material has a polarity, it will be dissolved in something which is polar in nature. You know that polarity is the partial charges which are developed in the particular compound. So when you have the non-polar substance, you will be having this that dissolved in the non-polar solvent. I am giving you a simple example of NaCl, sodium chloride. It is having the charges Na plus Cl minus. Similarly, our water is also having charges. Oxygen contains two partial charge and both the hydrogen contains one positive charge, partial. So because of the polarity in both, in your water, your NaCl is completely dissolved. So depending on the polarity, you have to remember one statement, light dissolves light. Aapka jaisa particular compound hai, waisa aapka solvent hona chahiye, same nature ka, tabhi wo dissolve hoga. Next important topic, chemical reaction. In this chapter, we have done three types of the reaction. Number one, nucleophilic substitution reaction, elimination reaction, and number three, reaction with metals. Reaction with metals are very less, which you can remember, but main thing is your electrophilic and nucleophilic reactions. Very, very important. So we are starting with the nucleophilic reaction. This one very important and very easy to remember in this particular, that is, आपके कार्बन से एक्स चला जा रहा है, कैसे जाएगा? माइनस बन के जाएगा. जब आपका एक्स माइनस बन के जाएगा तो कार्बन क्या हो जाएगा? पॉजिटिव. एंड कार्बन इज पॉजिटिव मींस इनकमिंग ग्रुप. सपोज वाई इज कमिंग, सो वाई शुड पजेस द नेगेटिव चार्ज ओनली. दैट इज व्हाई वी कॉल इट एज अ न्यूक्लियोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन. जहाँ से आपका एक्स गया वहीं पर आपके वाई का लग जाना, और वैसे ही सेम चार्जेस के साथ. सो दिस काइंड ऑफ द कंपाउंड फॉर्मेशन वी आर फॉरवर्डिंग reaction. So let us see the reactions. Achha, nucleophilic, the concept is also there in your 11th class, means you have already done that. See the structure. Nucleophile negatively charged, carbon partial positive, your X is partial negative. When X is going out, you are having the incoming of your nucleophile which is negatively charged. And after X, nickel pair. Depending on this, we go for having number of nucleophiles. We are having one table which contains number of nucleophiles. So you are able to see the reagent. Suppose you want to attach OH. Aap kya use karoge? NaOH use kar sakte ho, KOH use kar sakte ho. Okay, so what it can be? ROH, alcohol ban jayega. Suppose you have the water, and if you want to go for the addition of the water again, it is also going to form ROH. Similarly, your I reagent क्या use करोगे? NaI. अच्छा, suppose करो कि NaI use किया. Suppose I am having chloromethane. Any chloromethane, I am using NaI. As I know that I is going to replace the chlorine, my chlorine will be going with the Na, that is sodium. So what it is going to give? It is going to give me iodomethane plus NaCl. It is going to give me iodomethane plus NaCl. So this kind of the substitutions are taking place. You can go through this chapter, you can go through this table, and still if you have any doubts, you can ask me regarding this particular. See the mechanism. Substitution. Okay, substitution. Substitution nucleophilic by molecular. Unimolecular हमने देख लिया, जहाँ से आपका X जाता है ना, वहीं पे आपका Y लग जाना, nucleophile लग जाना. That is your SN1 reaction. Unimolecular. If you talk about bimolecular, I have given you the points of difference also in my notes, and which you have written very nicely in your test, which we have taken the first internal assessment. Probably all of them have written the difference between SN1 and SN2 mechanism. So that is completely good enough. If we talk about the mechanism, what is happening over here? आपका जो न्यूक्लियोफाइल आ रहा है वो पीछे से अटैक कर रहा है. SN1 में क्या था? न्यूक्लियोफाइल जहाँ से सी एल निकल रहा था वहीं पे अटैक कर रहा था. सो इस केस में क्या होगा? देयर विल बी चेंज इन द प्रोडक्ट. प्रोडक्ट की जो सिमेट्री है वो चेंज हो जाएगी. प्रोडक्ट का जो कॉन्फिग्रेशन है वो चेंज हो जाएगा. इज इट क्लियर? तो हम SN1 की जब बात कर रहे हैं तो दोनों पॉसिबल है. रिटेंशन भी पॉसिबल है, और क्या पॉसिबल है? इन्वर्जन भी पॉसिबल है. बट SN2 में ऑलवेज इन्वर्जन होगा. क्यों? क्योंकि आपका न्यूक्लियोफाइल पीछे से अटैक करता है. सो इट इज गोइंग टू चेंज द सिमेट्री ऑफ द कंपाउंड और यू कैन से कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑफ द कंपाउंड. This is the structure you are able to see. You are able to see how the nucleophiles, how the nucleophiles are attached over there. SN1, SN2 I have already given to you, so you can go from there. See, the reason behind that why when you are attacking from the back side, your primary is more favorable than secondary, it in turn tertiary. प्राइमरी को इजीली अवेलेबल फ्री रहेगा. आपका जो न्यूक्लियोफाइल आ रहा है पीछे से उसको रोकने के लिए आपके पास सिर्फ छोटे छोटे हाइड्रोजन है. सो न्यूक्लियोफाइल इजीली अटैक करेगा, इसलिए टर्शियरी में SN2 इजीली हो जाता है. सेकेंडरी में क्या होगा? दो बल्की ग्रुप्स है और आपका न्यूक्लियोफाइल को पीछे से अटैक करना है, तो क्या होगा? ये दो बल्की ग्रुप्स है ना, उसको रोकेंगे. दे आर द ऑब्स्टिकल ऑन द वे ऑफ योर इनकमिंग ग्रुप. वेन वी टॉक अबाउट योर टर्शियरी, yes, your SN1 is very simple. Transactor we are there, only we have OH level. So that is very simple one which we have seen. Yes, something very important over here. Let me talk about the chirality. What is chiral carbon? I gave you the clear idea that chiral carbon is the one this structure may carbon ke charo haath free hai, right? All the four hands are occupying one group on it, and let me tell you, you are able to see all the groups are different. It is holding all the groups different over here. Therefore this carbon, this start of the middle carbon is your chiral carbon. You can see it is chiral in the nature. So as it is having all the different hands over here, one more important thing, we are talking about that non-chiral organic objects superimpose mirror image. इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? आपके अगर दो glass है, एक glass के ऊपर दूसरा glass same रखा जा सकता है. When they are superimposable, we call it as a non-chiral object. Also, it is obtaining the mirror image. When you talk about two hands, एक हाथ और दूसरे हाथ को ऊपर रखेंगे तो सेम इम्पैक्ट नहीं होगा, मतलब कि सेम स्ट्रक्चर नहीं बनता. इसको आपको डाइवर्ट करना पड़ेगा, इसको आपको टर्न करना पड़ेगा, राइट? सो वेन यू टॉक अबाउट, ये क्या हुआ? सुपर नॉन सुपर इम्पोजेबल. वेन इट इज नॉन सुपर इम्पोजेबल, इट इज अ चिरल ऑब्जेक्ट. मिरर इमेजेस आर स्टिल फॉर्मड इन दिस वन ऑल्सो. दोनों में ही मिरर इमेज बनती है, बट एक सुपर इम्पोजेबल है, एक नॉन सुपर इम्पोजेबल है. तो जो नॉन सुपर इम्पोजेबल है वो चिरल कार्बन, और जो सुपर इम्पोजिबल है वो नॉन चिरल का. थोड़ा सा ट्विस्टेड है, बट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस. चला जाएगा, बिकॉज जनरली हम कार्बन की वैलेंसी किससे फुलफिल करते हैं, हाइड्रोजन से फुलफिल करते हैं, राइट। सो कंपल्सरी आपका जो एडजेसेंट कार्बन है वहीं से हाइड्रोजन को निकलना पड़ेगा, एंड वेन दिस पर्टिकुलर टू मॉलिक्यूल्स आर लॉस्ट इट रिजल्ट्स इनटू डबल बॉन्ड फॉर्मेशन। मतलब क्या आपका हेलोजन किस में कन्वर्ट हो गया, एल्कीन्स में कन्वर्ट हो गया। दिस इज व्हाट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर। सो देयर आर सो मेनी एग्जांपल्स गिवन ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर व्हिच यू कैन नोट डाउन। Yes, friend, this is also very important one कि आपका जो पर्टिकुलर अगर आपका alkene symmetrical नहीं है, unsymmetrical है, so in this case what is happening? See, you are having a double bond over in between. मतलब कि आप यहाँ पे क्या कर रहे हो, double bond जो form हो रहा है उसमें अगर आपको HBr डालना है तो there are two possibilities that your Br can be in which position. We talk about this two particular, ठीक है, आपके second number पे लगा हुआ है तो पॉसिबिलिटी क्या है, आपका ये कार्बन भी हाइड्रोजन लॉस कर सकता है, ये एक पॉसिबिलिटी हुई। तो डबल बॉन्ड कहाँ बनेगा, कार्बन नंबर वन और कार्बन नंबर टू के बीच में। बट अगर कार्बन नंबर थ्री हाइड्रोजन लॉस करता है तो डबल बॉन्ड की पोजीशन चेंज हो गई, दैट इज बिटवीन सेकंड एंड थर्ड। ओके, सो व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू ऑब्टेन, देयर आर टू पॉसिबिलिटीज, डियर स्टूडेंट, डबल बॉन्ड बिटवीन सेकंड एंड थर्ड कार्बन, डबल बॉन्ड बिटवीन फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड कार्बन। सो यू आर एबल टू सी द परसेंटेज 81% एंड 90%। सो दिस इज व्हाई दिस इज मोर फेवरेबल, इट इज मोर फेवरेबल बिकॉज इट सेज दैट व्हेन यू लूज द ब्रोमीन यू हैव टू टेक द हाइड्रोजन फ्रॉम द कार्बन व्हिच इज लेस इन नंबर। यहाँ पे दो है, यहाँ पे तीन है, तो कौन सा कम है, दो वाला कम है, राइट। सो यू हैव टू टेक वन हाइड्रोजन फ्रॉम दिस वन, एंड दैट इज द रीजन 81% ऑफ योर पेन टू इन पेन वन इन दैट इज 19%। आई होप यू आर गेटिंग द एलिमिनेशन रिएक्शन हाउ यू हैव टू इन एग्जाम्पल। सो दे विल बी आस्किंग यू नॉट डायरेक्टली, दे मे गिव यू द हाफ रिएक्शन एंड यू हैव टू कंप्लीट इट। सो डू नॉट गेट कंफ्यूज, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस रूल दैट हाइड्रोजन शुड बी टेकन फ्रॉम द कार्बन विच हैज लेस नंबर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन। इसको आप कैसे याद कर सकते हो, रिमेंबर लाइक मार्कोनिकोफ रूल। मार्कोनिकोफ रूल क्या कहता है, नेगेटिव ग्रुप कौन से कार्बन पे लगता है, जहाँ पे कम नंबर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन है। तो यहाँ पे भी क्या करना है, यू हैव टू टेक द हाइड्रोजन फ्रॉम द कार्बन विच इज लेस इन नंबर। इज इट क्लियर। रिएक्शन विद मेटल्स, यस, रिएक्शन विद मेटल्स आर आल्सो वी हैव सीन दिस। Next we will start with the nucleophilic reactions later on.